This is part three of a series answering a very short and completely wrong post. Let's conclude our examination of your short post, brother. Allahi, Allahi, lama sabachthani. These are words suggested by Islam as Jesus' last words. I've addressed your claim that these were the last words of Jesus in part two. There are two reasons these are not the last words of Jesus. In part two, I proved Jesus said words after this phrase, lama sabachthani, so these could not be his last words. Now, let's prove Jesus never said these words, Elahi, Elahi, so these are not Jesus' words, last or otherwise. Let's begin. First, we'll go through what Jesus actually said. And as often happens, as I begin trying to be thorough, I have to take a step back. Jesus was reciting scripture. So Jesus was not even the first to utter this statement. Jesus was reciting Psalms 22 verse 1 that Prophet David revealed and recorded. To the chief musician, set to the deer of the dawn, a psalm of David. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from helping me and from the words of my groaning? This question is what Jesus recited. My God, why have you forsaken me? Since Prophet David recorded this first in Hebrew, what Hebrew words did Prophet David use for my God? In the original Hebrew, David wrote, Eli, Eli. In the Strong's Concordance, this is Hebrew word number 410. In the Strong's, Hebrew number 410 is El, not Elah. But notice, this is Eli, Eli. The I suffix is my, making this my El. My God. Notice this is from the Hebrew, and the phonetic spelling and pronunciation is Eli, long E, not I, A, anything else. It's an E sound. Eli, the transliteration of the Hebrew noun El, meaning God, with the suffix I, which means my, Eli. My God. The I suffix means my, making this my El, my God. Eli means my God. It is not even a name, per se. So neither Prophet David nor Jesus quoting Psalms were saying the Arabic word Allah. But that will not stop someone desperate from waging the sounds like jihad.
Allah, Allah, lama sabaktani, insa Allah, Allah, lama taraktani. Sound similar? Allah, Allah, lama sabaktani, insa Allah, Allah, lama taraktani.
Sound similar?
The word Allah simply does not appear anywhere in the New Testament. Though some will lie and claim it does because something sounding like Allah can be found. So Jesus was reciting Psalms 22:1 as his final moment was approaching. Let's take a look at that verse now. Matthew 27:46, and about the ninth hour Jesus cried with a loud voice saying, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, that is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? We have seen that Jesus was reciting Psalms 22, verse 1. But there is something else going on with this verse that is unusual. I cannot think of another phrase besides this here and in Mark that provides Jesus' words in two languages in the same verse. Think about it for a moment. we're reading an English translation of the Greek. But that includes a phrase that has been recorded in the original Hebrew, as was recited by Jesus on the cross, followed up by an explanation in the Greek language of the main text. That is to say, or which means. So we have this first section is Greek, translated to English for our reading here. And about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, and the last section is recorded as Greek, and it's translated to English. That is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? But here in the middle, we see the original Hebrew language. I cannot think of another treatment of Jesus' words in this manner. And I'm not sure what to make of that. Try to think of any other statement Jesus made recorded in the Bible that first records the original Hebrew, then includes the translation into Greek. I'm just not sure what to make of that. But it does a great job destroying a false claim that the word Allah came out of Jesus' mouth while hanging on the cross, that Muhammad denied ever happened. And it is easy enough to find that Deedat is the proponent of this argument, if not the original inventor of the intellectually bankrupt fraud. And there is another aspect of this dimwit Deedat's rubbish that is completely backwards. Another example of the epic ignorance of this Islamic Ilahi Jihad is in the base words. We just examined the Hebrew basis for Eli, root word El for God, and suffix I meaning my. El is God, Eli is my God. But in Arabic, Ilah is a God, Allah is the God. Can you see the problem that damns the Islamic sounds like jihad? Eli, Allah. Eli is comprised of El and I, God, my. Allah is comprised of Al and La, the God. But there appears to be a problem. The syllable for God is not even at the same end of the word. Playing Eli, Elahi, Allah substitution games is intellectually bankrupt, or simply put, corrupt. But just so you know, I'm not making up a false claim against Deedat's stupidity. Let's hear it from Deedat the donkey himself, from his very mouth. First, he will compare Jehovah, Jehovah to Eli, Eli.
So I'm asking, does Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani sound to you like Jehovah, Jehovah, lama sabachthani?
Then, Abba, Abba to Eli, Eli.
I said, listen, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani. Does that sound to you like Abba, Abba, lama sabachthani? Abba means father in Hebrew.
Then, Allah, Allah.
He says, no. Then I said, listen, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani in Hebrew, Allah, Allah, lama taraktani in Arabic. Sound similar?
But let's look at another element of this speech. A hesitation.
In the 2,000 different languages in which the Christian world has translated the Bible, in the 2,000 different languages, the word Allah is there. It's not been, they have not been able to eliminate it.
Deedat knows. He is telling a bold-faced lie.
The word Allah is there. The word Allah is there.
He cannot state that simply without stammering and hesitating. Maybe, just maybe, Deedat feared the judgment liars receive. To be blunt, Deedat was an idiot of the first order, and he has likely led millions into hell with his deceptions. Don't be one of them. Did Jesus say, Elahi, Elahi, lama sabachthani? Nope. This is not a reference in the New Testament. hidden or otherwise, to the Arabic word Allah. The Arabic word Allah is not in the New Testament. Wouldn't you rather learn and believe the truth? The choice is yours. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.